Hello everybody, today I want to give a short demonstration how to stack asteroid images with the program ASTOM. On the left side of the screen you see the viewer of ASTOM, and on the right side you see the stack menu. Now the first thing to do is of course to add some images to the stack menu. So we go to images, the first step, and we press browse. I have here 6 images of Vesta. And they were taken in a period of about 2 hours. The first one 1937 hours and the last one 2140. So a little more than 2 hours. Okay, we add them to the list. And let's first stack them on with alignment on the stars. So I select star alignment. This is the default one. And we just press the button stack images. There we go. It's now stacking the 6 images, so it will line on the stars, so the stars will be nice round, and most likely the asteroid will show a track on the image. Okay, stacking is finished. We have one big line through the image. I think it's an aeroplane. I see 2 lines, but anyhow, that happens. And here I see, a small track. I'm pretty sure it's the asteroid Vesta, but let's have a look. If I move around with the mouse on the image, you can see on the left side that the position stays 0. And also here, there's no northeast arrow indicator. So, of course, this image is not solved. So the first step to do is to solve the image. So we press simply solve. And in no time it will be solved. And when I move around with the mouse, on the left bottom side I see the position where my mouse is. So it's moving. Well, if that's done, then we go to the new tool under tools. There's an option asteroid annotation. So we can annotate any asteroid in the image. Now let's press on that one. And I get a menu annotate asteroids using a database, and it will use up to asteroid number 10,000, but we can also go to 500,000 and some other data, and we just press annotate. Okay, that goes pretty quick, and you see that this first track is clearly marked as Vesta, so asteroid number 4. And the magnitude is 8 points and something. And I see another asteroid here, asteroid number 233, with the name Asteropy. Okay, that's nice. The only problem is that faint asteroids, I don't think we'll see them, maybe here, some faint indication. But because the asteroid is moving, we don't get, let's say, single point, and the light is lost, or let's say spread that over the track. So let's the next time try to align not on the stars but on the asteroid. So what we have to do, we go to the stack menu again, and we go to tab alignment, and we change from star alignment to manual on one star. And as soon as you do that, you can see in the image list that they all turn red. Red means there is no reference star or point. So we have to go to all the images and we have to mark our reference point. So let's double click on the first one. And I know this is the Vesta asteroid. And as soon as I click on that one, you get a green circle around it. Means that it's locking on the asteroid. And in the image list, this first image gets an X and Y position, so where the asteroid is. So let's go to the next one. You can either double click or you can just click view image. You mark again the asteroid, and we go to all the whole list, mark every time the asteroid. Okay, I think all marked. Let's check them again. So they're all green here. This one has a marker. This has a marker. This has a marker. So for all images the asteroid is marked. And on the list you see that for every X and Y position there's a number added indicating where the asteroid is on the image. Now again we can just press stack images, so let's do that. And hopefully the asteroid will be a single point and the stars will have trails or tracks. Okay, done. Yeah, you can see nicely here that this is Vesta, is a single dot, so it has nicely aligned on the asteroid. And here's a second one. I think this is our second asteroid. So it all works. But yeah, we like to have an annotation for these asteroids. But you see, if I move the mouse around, let's say the position stays zero. This image is not solved. But how can we solve such an image? That's not so easy because the stars are all, yeah, have trails. Well, that's possible if we solve the reference image. Well, the reference image in ASTAP is always the one with the lowest half flux diameter value. So if they are sorted on HFD, half flux diameter, this one is the one with the lowest value. Well, let's show this again, this image, double click on it. And let's solve this image. So we go to the solve button and we just press solve. Okay, solved. So when I move now the mouse, the position changes and we have a northeast arrow. So that's good. Well, then it's important to save it. So we save this file, overwrite it, and then we start, we'll align again the images. Let me quickly check if it's still the markers are good. Yes, so we can now just stack the images again. And because the reference image has a solution, ASTAP will use this image solution for the final image. So let's stack. So we have the same image as the previous stack, so it's all nicely aligned around Vesta. And the other asteroid is here, but there's a big difference. On the left bottom you can see that a position is indicated. So this is indicating that the image is solved. And again you see on the top menu you see a northeast arrow. So this image is not only stacked but also solved, using the solution from the reference image. So now we can simply add an annotation, asteroid annotation. So we go to tools and we go to menu asteroid annotation. Click on that one again, and there are our annotations. So Vesta is marked, also Asteropi is marked. This one is still too faint. Also here I think we don't have any positive identification, but of course this is magnitude 16, so faint. But this shows the principle. So if you have enough images stacked on let's say manual on one asteroid, then we most likely will see fainter asteroids in the final image. This is the end of our demonstration. I hope it's useful. Thanks for your attention.